بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله نستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلله فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله ونشهد أن سيدنا مولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله تعالى آله وأصحابه وسلم تسليما كثيرا كثيرا سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم رَبِّ اشْرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي وَيَسِّرْ لِي أَمْرِي وَاحْلُلْ عُقْدَةً مِّن لِّسَانِي يَفْقَهُوا قَوْلِي السَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ and welcome to the Al Balagh Academy webinar on COVID-19 vaccinations, or shall I say the controversy around the COVID-19 vaccinations. Now, before I begin this particular webinar, there's a couple of things that I need to clarify, and then inshallah we can get straight into the actual presentations. We have a short presentation by Dr. Mohammed Muniri. And then after that, we will have a Q&A panel discussion. So some of these questions are probably some of the most important questions that people do ask related to COVID-19 vaccinations in particular, but also this general sort of overview around COVID-19 in itself. And then in addition to that, what we'll have is for the last sort of 20 minutes, even 30 minutes possibly, we will open up questions to yourselves, the viewers. So you'll have the opportunity to ask any additional questions. Hopefully most of them will already have been addressed because some of these questions are chosen very carefully to address the main concerns that people have. Now, before I begin, there's a couple of things I really want to say sort of highlight predominantly because these are very important things. OK, so we are going to address the issue of COVID-19. There's many, many different webinars that are out there at the moment. But the unique feature of what we want to do in this particular webinar is give the Islamic stance or the Islamic perspective to the issues around COVID-19 and more in particular, the COVID-19 vaccines. Okay, so that's the main feature today. Now, before I begin that, there is something that always we should always remember. There is a qaida within the Holy Quran. So there's a kind of a principle in the Holy Quran, which clearly states and makes it very clear for us. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِن جَاءَكُمْ فَاسِقٌ بِنَبَئٍ فَتَبَيَّنُوا So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, all those who believe, if a fasiq, somebody who's sinner, somebody who's not upright, somebody who's not adil, comes to you with some news of his, then get it clarified. Now this is a qaida in the Holy Quran. And then there is another qaida in the Holy Quran, فَاسْأَلُوا أَهْلَ ذِكْرِ إِن كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ And this is another very important qaida, is ask those people, the Ahlul Dhikr. And Ahlul Dhikr, there is a slight difference of opinion in terms of who they are, but the majority of people agree that this is referring to the ulama of knowledge and interest and expertise within this particular area. So ask those people who have expertise, especially of the Sharia, as well as the additional sciences that are required for you to understand the situation in general. Ask them if you do not know. So these are two qaidas that are found in the Holy Quran that we're going to take a particular focus and attention to. So for that reason, before I continue, there is one other very, very important thing that I'm going to make sure, which is very, very clear for the viewers in particular. For somebody who's been involved in this, and I'm hearing all sorts of wonderful arguments and discussions and debates out there, let's get the parameters right here. Okay, so what is this Al Balagh webinar going to be about? Now we have two extremes. We have one extreme, which is completely anti-vax. They are not interested in vaccinations altogether. They feel there's some kind of either conspiracy or they are some of the most dangerous things that we have in terms of what science has created in the real world today. Okay, so we're not interested in that group because they have their own understanding. They're not open to any kind of proof or discussion. They've already made their mind up. So this webinar does not address those kind of individuals. Okay. The other end, we have those individuals who are what we say, sami'na wa ata'na. Whatever we hear, we follow. So that group, again, these are individuals who basically, if science tells us, then we will accept it. So that's the other end of the spectrum. So that group of people, they've already made their mind up as well. So we're interested in that middle group of people, those people who truly want to know the reality as much as we possibly can know about the vaccinations, okay, and about COVID. So we're interested in that particular group of people. And before I continue, I just want to emphasize something that's very, very important. And this is something that I clearly want to put straight. We need to distinguish between real conspiracies and a conspiracy theory. We need to make sure that we distinguish between the two. Let me just very briefly explain, because people do believe in real conspiracies, okay? And that's acceptable. And then there are those people who believe in conspiracy theories, which can be questionable. So let me differentiate between the two types of people. There are those people who believe in conventional thinking, okay? So conventional thinking meaning that you have a healthy skepticism. So you have a healthy sense of being skeptical about what's out there. That is something which the verse of the Quran refers to. That's very clear. The Quran says that if somebody comes to you and clearly you know that they're not adil, they're not upright in their character, and you are not too sure about whether you can trust them, then get that information clarified. So clearly, healthy skepticism is something which is encouraged in Islam. The second thing is, and this is very important, that they are responsive to evidence. If there is proof and there is evidence there, they are clearly responsive to that. They will realize and appreciate that I'm asking somebody who has some expertise in the area. They are also somebody who is trustworthy. They're upright in their character. They are accountable to the community. Then those are the kind of people they would ask, and then they will get their proof, because we cannot possibly know every little detail about everything. Okay, now finally, the last thing is that there is coherence, and this is really important, that there is coherence in what you are believing. In other words, you don't accept one particular understanding and coherence in one area, yet that contradicts some other beliefs that you have. So it has to be very coherent. The proof that's provided must fit a general understanding that is coherent. Now, people who believe in conspirational in thinking, i.e. believe in all sorts of conspiracy theories, they fall into three traps. The first is they have overriding suspicion. Their suspicion goes beyond the norm, okay? They go well beyond their understanding of something which you would think, a bit far-fetched, okay, to some degree. Or they may also have an over-interpretation of evidence. So what they do is they'll introduce evidence to you from probably sources which are not even expert sources, only because it supports their argument. And they will over-interpret just to put a point forward. And finally, they are contradictory. They are not coherent, because what they do is they will apply this form of conspiracy to one thing, yet will not allow for that to encroach on another concept, which they have a certain alternate bias to. So for that reason, there is some lack of serious coherence there. So these are things that we need to be careful about when we get our information and knowledge. So we accept that there have been real conspiracies out there. Let me give you one or two, three examples. There's been the conspiracy, for example, Volkswagen conspired to cheat emissions tests for their diesel engines. Number two, the US National Security Agency secretly spied on civilian internet users. Number three, the tobacco industry deceived the public about harmful health effects of smoking. So there are certain level of conspiracy that is out there, which is real and it's acceptable. But we need to follow a systematic way and approach to understand this. So if you are one of those two extremes, the far right or the far left, then I'm afraid this webinar is not for you. But those of you who truly want to know and you want to gain a good understanding of what's going on, then inshallah, you will really benefit from this. And all we want to do is we want to inform you so that you have an informed choice, you have the understanding and knowledge, and then now it's down to you to make your decision. So without further ado, I'm going to first make reference to our first panelist who's done a fantastic piece of work, and he's going around. Now, before I begin to introduce him, like I said before, so this is Dr. Mohammed Munir. Now, Dr. Mohammed Munir is what we would consider, I consider, as a Muslim scientist.